The uptake of silverfish, locally and widely known as mokene, has progressively increased to at least 30%, mainly due to its nutritious functions. This has equally encouraged its fishing in water bodies by most of the fishers. Against this background, the Minister of State for Fisheries, Helen Adoa, has issued clarity on the fact that fishing of silverfish has not been banned, but was instead cautioning against the rampant use of illegal fishing methods.
I want this to be clear, and I don't want it again to be manipulated. I am saying currently, whoever is fishing well is allowed up to 30th. You pay a license. But after 30th, and you have not paid your license, I am sorry. When you become a culprit, you have to be taken to your police station of your district, and you have to face the law.
The minister has, however, cautioned the Fisheries Protection Unit to return a number of impounded items to the fishermen.
Fishermen say their motorcycles and vehicles are impounded, and you see some people who are not even soldiers using them. So if you impound a motorcycle and a vehicle, why do you give a civilian to use? Civilians say, let me use it out of the little money or what? So this must stop. I want everything released between now and 30th.
Minister Adoa further lashed out at FPU Invijo soldiers for torturing people in fishing communities.
A young man who was brought to me limping, beaten, that he refused to carry the net. They forced him to carry the net. That he carry this net, we take your photo. The boy said, no, that is not my net. You can kill me, but that's not my net. And I was shocked. APU had stopped beating and what? But I was shocked to find that this man was treated in Kampala Central Police Station, and was beating the leg as a problem. So I think I condemn this.
The Ministry of Agriculture has now embarked on the review and update of fishing regulations under the new Fisheries and Aquaculture Act 2023. Minister Adoa has revealed that the process is consultative and will incorporate ideas and proposals from different stakeholders, including fishers, traders and community leaders. Derek Asaba, reporting for the news.